unit, consider it in the light and in the context of what Jesus spoke about in Matthew chapter 19. And that was, from the beginning of time, it was not so. From the beginning of time, he says, God made man and woman. Now, when you study this carefully and you look at this and you see every other occurrences, not just in the Synoptic Gospel, but throughout the Bible, and I will challenge you.
Thank you.
You will always see man and woman. You will never see woman and man. It's not a typo error, it's not a mistake. Study it carefully. You will always see man and woman. You will always see husbands and wives throughout the scriptures.
Amen.
Genesis to Revelation, believe me, I read it a couple of times. You will always see man and woman. Why? The Bible explains why you should see man and woman. Because the Bible says that man was made first. This is the reason why man was created first. That's why you see man and woman. Because man came and then woman came from man's side. So from the beginning of time, God made man first and then the woman came from man's side. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 23 says this: For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church and the savior of the body. The savior of the body. Who is the husband? He's the head of the wife. Now, some of you women, don't throw those stones at me, because it's the Bible, you'll be sinning. The husband is the head of the wife. Let me say that again. The husband is the head of the wife.
Amen.
It's a Greek word called kephale. Kephale. He is the head. You know what it means? It means he is superior. You know what? If you listen to this carefully, you'll receive a revelation that you've never seen before. You'll receive a revelation that you've never seen before. It means he's superior. So God the Father is designated as head of Christ in his manifestation as man, or as divinity is superior to humanity. Watch this now. So here's what the Bible means by God is the head of Christ. As Christ is the head of the church or humanity.
Amen.
Watch how important this is. The different role from a man and a woman is that God had made man the head, and this Greek word is translated in the same sense as Christ is the head of the church. So the husband or the man is head of the wife. These are in the same verse in Ephesians 5 and 23, but they are the exact same Greek word meaning.
Amen.
You can catch that a little later.
Amen.
And some of you that can't catch it, let me break it down for you. God decided that he will come in the form of human being. And he came in a form, and he said this: Lo, I come in the volume of a book to do thy will, O God. To do thy will, O God. I came in the volume of a book to do thy will, as it is written of me. So guess what God did? God became man. He took on human flesh, bled, died, rose again. He came on earth. And he was subject. Remember, when they were in heaven, he said, Let us make man in our image. When they were in heaven, he said, let us make man in our image and in our likeness. But God, through the person of Jesus Christ, came in the form of flesh, came to earth and submitted himself unto Father. And even though in heaven or in divinity, they were all equal, but Jesus shared that off. He would never be a spirit again. So the scripture here is telling us just how Jesus submitted everything to God. He says, Father, I have finished. He says, Father, it is finished. It is done. He said, now my spirit I command into your hand. Jesus, everything he did was concerning his Father. He said, his Father. I go unto my Father. He said, you pray unto me whatever my Father says. He says, my Father's will. Everything he did, he submitted unto God the Father.
Amen.
This is the same word head that the Bible uses for a woman, that a man is the head of his wife as Christ is the head of the church. In other words, women, you should honor your husbands with reverence.
Amen. Amen.
It's the quietest I ever hear a church in my life. You all know I'm not the whole assembly. May God be to break that mold. So man is the head. I didn't say that. I didn't put it in. That's what the Bible says. God has ordained for man just to have a different role. Now light up now, man. It's gonna be better, man. Come on, light up. So man is the head. So man is the head just because Christ is the head of the church. God is the head of Christ. Man is the head of his home. He's the head of his wife.
Amen.
You remember what I started saying? Whenever we neglect or we ignore the divine will of God, then that's when we get problems. We don't get problems unless we neglect his divine will. That's when problems and temptations come in. According to the scripture, the mystery of two becoming one. Here's what Jesus says. Let's look at the scriptures now. Let's look at our text. He said in our text, have you not read that the beginning, verse 12, and he answered and said unto them, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female? Verse 5. And he said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother and cleave unto his wife.
Amen.
Now, about 2 years ago, I did a survey in the Bohemian culture. And I don't want anyone to raise their hands. Please do not raise your hand, men. Because God has called us to peace. Amen. And if you raise your hand, trust me, you ain't gonna get no peace. So please don't raise your hands. I did a survey several years ago. And to make a long story short, it was basically how many men, if their mother and their wife were drowning simultaneously, who would you save? And 90% of men said their ma. 90% of men said, I will say my mommy, honey, I can see you up there later. It's a serious thing.
Yeah.
It's a serious thing. Maybe because of our culture. I don't know. when culture cannot trump the word of God. Culture cannot trump the word of God. Man, culture cannot trump the word of God. 90% of the man says, I'll save my mother. Unapologetic. I was shocked. But then I understood that that's just the culture, the Bahamian culture. I can save my mother. You think I can leave my mother drowning? I can get another wife. I can't get another mother. That's the mentality most of the people see. I can get another wife. I can get another woman. Listen, I can't get another woman. You see how you think I can get another one of them? Thank God.